certain types of driving rhythms just have like a profound effect on people. It's not just about the rhythm, it's like the actual sounds themselves, I feel like, and that's something that I think those guys are super good at. Animal Collective, I feel like the names and the masks in the beginning were a way to let the music happen in a natural way without feeling like it was really us up there. The more I sit with the song, the more I kind of want to hide what's really going on, or I feel like often I'll change lyrics or change the sound of the voice so that it's a little bit harder to decipher that feeling. You know, I could talk to somebody after the show and it was like, I could talk about what happened up there, but it wasn't really me. First time I heard them, I saw the Around the World video. Sort of just gotten wind of electronic music and was hearing a lot of stuff that I'd never heard before. Even though I'm not much of a dancer myself, at least not publicly, there's something about the ritualness of it that makes a lot of sense to me. Was one of the few things my brother and I could really agree on. My brother's a couple years older than I am, and Homework, the first Daft Punk album, was something we could play in the car together. There weren't many albums like that. There was an Animal Collective album where we wanted to do a remix of one of the songs, and we really wanted them to do one. They said they don't really do that kind of thing anymore. I asked them again when I did a solo album a couple of years after that. Just, I figured it was worth a shot. They said they don't do that kind of thing anymore. But maybe they'd be interested in doing something together. And then it was maybe a year and a half after that, they asked if I'd come to Paris and work on something. In the weeks leading up to it, I was really nervous. The thing I was most sort of concerned about was having kind of on the spot to come up with something really quickly, because I knew we'd only have 3 days to do it. I usually do things sort of the opposite way, where I spend a lot of time with a piece of music. Going in and just really like nailing something quickly, I didn't think I'd be very good at. We went down to the main studio part, and they set up a bunch of microphones to see which one might be sound good with the song and my voice. And then it was just like, okay, do something good. I was kind of trying a bunch of different things, and nothing really was sounding that good. But then I think I went back to the microphone to lay down something to remember, and thought of something else while I was going out there, and I could see them in the studio kind of nodding their heads. So it was sort of right at the last moment that we came up with something that we all liked. For better or for worse, everything I do is rhythmic. There was a point really early on when I was first starting to play drums that I realized I was never gonna be able to like technically be super good. So I thought I would try to focus on making rhythms that really suited the music or try to complement whatever was going on with the rest of the sound. With live drumming, I'm almost exclusively trying to just match or complement the rest of the music somehow. But sampling drums, it's all about getting this short snippet of sound that, once it's repeated, has some kind of visceral impact. The humanness or the emotion of music that I've been a part of is somewhat hidden in the end result. The impulse is to reveal something that's real and true. Right away, it's like a huge honor for me. But to talk about it more than that is still a little bit difficult at this point. But something I like a lot about Daft Punk, every album seems to be something completely different. And I feel like they challenge themselves to kind of go someplace new. And it was cool for me to see that a little bit, how they went about crafting the sounds and how, instead of sampling an old piece of music, it was like recording things in an old way to make something that kind of sounds like it was sampling something old, but which in turn kind of makes it sound new, if you know what I mean. Because it's very repetitive, like a sample or like a short piece of sound, but it's also got these little sonic details that come from a live performance when you're playing an instrument, and it's kind of this weird combination of machine-like and robotic, but also has these imperfections to it. It's wanting to remember something that was really good, that's old, that's kind of been forgotten. I feel like it's a cool way to say thanks for the inspiration or influence. Lucky.